Sentry's rolling out a new feature that lets you take your application logs and send them into Sentry as structured logs. Once they're in Sentry, you can search and query them like you normally would logs, but we're adding some additional things to it. We want to be able to use these logs to help troubleshoot and debug problems inside of your applications. So when you get an issue pop up inside of Sentry, you'll be able to see the logs that are related to the issue that's happening. We want to make these logs actionable and make it easier to help you solve real problems inside of your environment. I thought I'd take it for a spin and show you how easy it is to get started. Let's check it out. So here we are in Sentry. I'm going to go into the Explore view, and I'm going to drop into the Logs option, and I'll be in the new log screen that shows all the logs that I'm collecting for the environments and projects that I have selected. So I've got my unborked project selected here. I could choose multiple of these, but I'm selecting my front end and my back end here. I have all the normal search options that I would expect, things like time and date range and environments, but I can also come in here and start to search for either properties or just raw text. So I can come in here and type in Cody, for example, and I'm going to see every log that has Cody involved in it. Now I can also combine this with the property-based search, and that's that structured logs concept. I can come in and type in severity, and I can start to look up different severities of logs. So in my case, I'm going to come in, I'm going to choose error and warn, and I'll hit search. And now I'm going to see all of those logs that are available. Now I'm not seeing quite the information I wanted to see here normally, so I can come in and click here. Maybe I drop off the warn, include info instead, and I can hit search, and that expands back out and it updates really quickly. Now I can come up to this chart view. I can click and drag to filter down by specific time ranges. So if I see a spike in information, I can come in and dive really closely to see what was happening at that point. So again, trying to make this actionable so it's easy to triage problems inside of your environment. I can come into these log entries, expand them out, and I can see all the properties that we're collecting on top of these logs. Again, the structured logs concept. These properties right here are ones that I've pushed in from my application directly, but we also collect a bunch of things by default also. Now, in my case, I've already brought in a column for the SDK in use, and I did that by coming in here, selecting the three dots, and choosing to add that to a table column. So we can quickly add in additional properties that are going to give you the information that matters to you. In this case, now I can see all the logs, and specifically which SDK those logs are coming from, and just makes it easier for me to understand what's happening inside of my application. Now let's jump into my application and see how I brought these in. I'll go down to my app, and now I'm in the instrument.ts file inside of my backend, which is a node server. Inside here, I've added this experiments directive and I brought in enable logs and set it to true here. So now logging is available inside of my Sentry SDK. So now I'll drop into one of my API routes here. And I can see I've brought in the logger function here from that Sentry node SDK. So I've destructured that out and now I can use that throughout my application. So down here, I've got logger.info in use and I'm bringing in a message. Now I'm also using logger.formattext and I'm bringing in that structured object of the username. And so it's really easy to start bringing in more context and information that you want to be able to send into Sentry to be able to search off of. We've really focused a lot on developer experience and wanted to make sure that you can bring a ton of useful information into Sentry from your applications. A few lines down, you can see I'm bringing in a logger.warn. And so we expose a bunch of different types of log messages that you can bring into Sentry from your app. Beyond that, we have different integrations. For example, I could bring in the console logger integration that'll take all the console logs and different types of them and send them into Sentry automatically. So again, making it easier to bring that information in. We're really excited to get structured logs in front of everybody and have you use them inside of your applications. We'd love for you to take it for a spin, try it out, and let us know how we can make it better and what you want to see out of this feature. Talk to you soon.